We are talking tonight about fix your eyes on Jesus. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Fix your attention on Jesus, because everything in this world is after your attention. Everything in this world is fighting for your attention. Can I have your attention? Can I have your attention? Your phone is screaming. Can I have your attention? Can I have your attention? Netflix is screaming. Can I have your attention? Can I have your attention? Your kids are screaming. Can I have your attention? Can I have your attention? Your tummy is screaming. Can I have your attention? Can I have your attention? Right? Everything in this world is fighting for your attention, but we need to fix our eyes on Jesus, right? We're just living in a day and age where everything is so fast, everything is so quick, and it's like, where's my attention? Where's my attention? We're so distracted. Can anybody agree, right? We're driving distracted. We're going to school distracted. You're working distracted. I mean, like, how can you be posting? Aren't you at a job? I'm distracted, right? Distracted. But we have to make a choice, okay? Fix your eyes on Jesus is your choice. It's not just for the few. I mean, the few choose. All are chosen, but few choose. So we need to choose to fix our eyes on Jesus. And that doesn't mean that we just go and look at the sky. We walk around looking at our Bible, fixing my eyes on Jesus, fixing my eyes on Jesus. You know, we need to fix our eyes on his word. We need to fix our eyes on who we are in him. That's where we need to fix our attention. Right? We have to make the choice to fix our eyes on Jesus, making Jesus and his word the focus of our life, the focus of our whole life, fixing our eyes on Jesus, because without him, remember, we can do nothing. Without him, we are nothing. And the moment we think we can do it on our own is when we start making a hot mess of our life. The moment we think we can do it without Jesus, we're like, oh yeah, I could do this, I could do that. The moment you get off track, your life starts looking like a train wreck real quick. Why? Because we start to think we know it all, right? Oh, my parents did it this way. Everybody else is doing it this way. You know, it's not that bad. It's not that bad until it's bad. But we have to make Jesus the center of our lives. We need to make Jesus the motivation of our lives. Do you know that you were his motivation? You're the center of his life. You're the joy set before him. He should be the joy set before us. But we're living in a distracted time, when the joy that's set before us is an ice cream. The joy that's set before us, come on, is when is work over? The joy that's set before us, why? We're always looking for what's to come, what's to come, what's to come, because we're distracted. And we're living in a time with social media, it's like you can barely enjoy your own moment. You can barely enjoy what you're doing because you're trying to get a picture of it. You're trying to make something happen that wasn't even happening. And it's like, just enjoy the moment. Enjoy all that God has for you. Make Jesus the aim of your life. Make Jesus the aim of your whole, like, being. Your whole, make Jesus the application of your life. How are we going to apply this? How are we going to do this? We hear the word, we apply the word. We hear the word, right? Pastor Jan always talks about it. It's all about Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, come on, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, back again Monday. Why? Because we need to take this word, put it in our hearts, and get it out there in the world, okay? Because, you know, we can put our Sunday's best on. We all look cute. Like, all y'all look cute. Everybody looks really good tonight. And y'all look, but it's when you get out there and you start fighting with your spouse, you start fighting with your kids, you start fighting about your money. That's when the crazy you comes out. Crazy you didn't come out here in the sanctuary looking all dignified and looking all good. Crazy you don't come out, right? You're receiving the word. Faith is going out. The word is going out. You're receiving the word. It's that we have to apply it. We have to apply it when we're out there. So we need to look to Jesus. We need to set Jesus as the center of our life, the focus of our life, the motivation of our life, the aim of our life. And what was Jesus? Love. Jesus is love, for God so loved the world. Come on, he sent Jesus. That's the motivation of our life. Love, 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 right? The choice of what you choose to focus on is completely up to you. Nobody can make you focus on the negative. Nobody can make you focus on the ugly. Nobody can make you focus. You choose it. I don't care who's telling you what. They can't make you focus. You have to choose and surrender your will to them. You choose and surrender your thoughts to them. You choose and surrender. How about you surrender your will to Jesus? How about you surrender your thoughts to his word? How about we start surrendering, right? But sometimes the people are louder. Why? Because we're not spending time in the word. We're missing church. With COVID, it got easy. Oh, yeah, I'll just catch it online. And then you start missing the live stream. Oh, I'll just catch it on the YouTube. And then you start. And then all of a sudden, it's like, what happened to so-and-so? Oh, don't be the so-and-so. You choose that. You choose that life. You choose that because it's so easy to just start going a little bit backwards, a little bit backwards, a little bit backwards. And you're like, man, how did I get so far? How did I get... It's the same with a relationship. You stop talking to somebody for a little while. You stop texting. You stop connecting. You stop going out. And before you know it, it's like, what was that friend I had? Yeah. And there you are with Jesus. And he's like, come to me. Come on. You need some rest. You need some peace. Come to me. I'm right here. I'm a knocking. You got to open the door. Let Jesus be the focus of our lives. And what you choose to focus on is completely up to you. I mean, if I could make you focus on Jesus, dude, if I could make me focus on Jesus all the time, I would do it. But I have to make the choice, right? You have to make the choice. We have to make the choice. Why? Because we have a destiny to fulfill here on this earth. How many of you believe that you have a destiny to fulfill? You weren't just born on this earth by, whoop, you was an accident. No, I wasn't. Yeah, we just had you. You just, whoop, popped in there. Nope, God had a plan for me. God had a plan for you. I wasn't just some special addition. Yeah, I am a special addition to this family, to this house, right? Come on, to this world. But you have to choose to focus on Jesus so you can fulfill your destiny, right? Choose to fulfill it. Fix your eyes on Jesus and run your race with endurance. It's going to take some endurance. It's going to take some perseverance. Come on. Hebrews 12:1. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a huge crowd of witnesses to the life of faith, there's so many of others saying, God did it for me. He'll do it for you. God healed me, he'll heal you. God moved a mountain, he'll move yours. Come on. There's a crowd of witnesses saying, God will do it for you because he did it for me. Right? Let us strip off. Whoa, here we go. Time to take it off. Every weight that slows us down, especially the sin that so easily trips us up. Man, you know what trips you up because it's usually the same thing over and over and over again. Let it go. Let it go, right? Sergio was over my house. Tristan was over my house. We're working on this project. And I've been a little bit consumed with, like, what is going to happen to this generation that has, like, 19-hour screen time? You know, like, what is going to happen to this generation that has, like, 19 hours of video games? And, like, you ain't getting paid to do it. Like, this is a hobby. It's not a job, okay? And I'm, like, sometimes I get a little bit, like, I mean, I need to save them all. How am I going to do this? And Sergio's like, okay, calm down. And everybody's like, okay, whip out your screen time. And some people got a little nervous, but it's okay. Not everybody did. But Tristan's like opening his screen time. I was like, okay, not bad. All right. I'm impressed. Okay. And then he's like opening mine, showing me how to read it. And it was just pretty cool. But anyways, I was just like, I can get consumed. Like, I mean, we don't have the end result of what's going to happen to the generation that just... You know, like 19 hours is a problem. In case you didn't think that was a problem, it's a problem. There's a big problem. Anything over like a couple hours a day, it's a problem, okay? So, and then I'm like, but how do I get them to see it? Do you know what I mean? Because I can want change, but like, how do I get them to see it? And Sergio's like, Sash, if we could get everybody to see it, that, okay, I don't spend that much. Yes, you do. I don't eat that much. Yes, you do. I don't, you know, and I was like, man, it's true. We're all doomed, okay? That's it. You know, it was just so funny that it's like, I can get focused and I'm like, I gotta help this generation. And then Sergio's like, you gotta help us all. Okay, you gotta help us all. And it's true. You can't just focus in on like one issue. We all have to have a revelation from the Word, a revelation from the Holy Spirit on these areas that trip us up, that these areas that we personally get caught up in. Because what you get caught up in, I may not get caught up in. What I get caught up in, you may not get caught up in. But whatever it is, we need to strip it off. Whatever it is, we need to let it go. Whatever is holding us back, the time is now. The time is now to let it go, right? Let it go. Strip it off. And let us run with endurance the race that God has set before us. You can't be running your race with all this baggage. You can't be running your race with all the baggage of the past relationships, all the baggage of you too many chips, all the baggage of all them late nights of scrolling and rolling and rolling, and you don't got no roly. All you got is a poly. Come on. All this baggage, and you're trying to run your race to fulfill God's plan for you, and you just holding on. Let it go. Let it go so that you could run your race, right? That God has set before you. Don't waste your life running someone else's race. Don't get caught up in somebody else's blog, somebody else's ministry, somebody else's YouTube page, somebody else's, you know, whatever. Don't waste your life running somebody else's race. When God has a special plan for you, God has a special plan for you. Discover God's plan for your life and persevere no matter what comes your way. Discover God's plan. When you know the why, you can endure anything. Discover God's plan for your life, right? And persevere no matter what comes your way. Run your race. And you know what? You can persevere and you can endure because you're not alone in your race. You're not alone. You're never alone. You've got Jesus. Come on, you got this family. You got love life. You're never alone. Fix your eyes on Jesus because he is with you. He is the only one that's not going to let you down. Sometimes you got your eyes fixed on a person. They're going to let you down. Fix your eyes on Jesus. He's the only one that is always with you, right? Fix your eyes on Jesus. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Man, it's going to be on repeat tonight. Fix your eyes, fix your eyes, fix your eyes. Why? Because they are not fixed. They broken. That's why we need this message. Come on. Fix our eyes on Jesus and look away from all that distracts you. Do you know that you got to make the decision to look away? You got to make the decision to turn your focus. Nobody can do it for you. Look away from all that distracts you. Fix your eyes on Jesus and focus in on him alone. Hebrews 12:2, looking away from all that will distract us and focusing our eyes on Jesus, who is the author, creator, and completer, perfecter of faith, the first reason for our belief and the one who brings our faith into maturity, who for the joy, the excitement, come on, of accomplishing the goal. We got any goal setters? We got any goal achievers in the place? Come on, we just like Jesus, we got the joy set before him, endured the cross, disregarding the shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God, revealing his deity, his authority, and the completion. It is finished at his work. Look away. Change your focus from whatever is distracting you and look to Jesus. So we sometimes are like, I'm not going to do that sin. 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 And what is your focus on? That sin, right? You're saying it. You're speaking it. Your whole focus is like, I'm not going to eat that. I'm not going to eat that. I'm not going to eat that. That enchilada. By the end of the day, you said enchilada 50 million times. So you know what you're going to do? You're going to eat not one, but the whole pan. Right? That's what happens. That's what happens. Like, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to go to that website. I'm not going to do that. Come on. I'm not going to play video games all night. I am going to go to bed at a decent time. I'm not going to. I'm not going to. I'm not going to. I'm not going to. And what are you doing? You're saying it over and over and over. Your whole focus is, I'm not. I'm not. I'm not. But your focus is, I am. I am. I am. That's what we got to fix our eyes on Jesus. We got to fix our eyes on Jesus. We need to start making positive confessions. You say that you will overcome this. Get an accountability partner. Whatever it is that you got to do, you need to find God's word. You need to find an answer in God's word to your problem. And then you speak the answer. You speak the answer. You speak the answer. I am an overcomer. I am an overcomer. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I am the head and not the tail. Come on. You speak the answer. Speak the answer. Speak the answer. And break up with the problem. Break up with the problem. Look away. Change your focus from whatever's distracting you and look to Jesus. Discover who you are in Him. You don't even know your true self until you know Jesus. You don't even know who you really are until you discover who you are in Him, who you are in Christ Jesus. You already have the victory in Him. Fix your eyes on Jesus and study, meditate, and reflect on the victory at the cross. The victory at the cross. Hebrews 12:3 is amplified. Just consider, study, reflect, and meditate on Jesus, who endured from sinners such bitter hostility against Him. Consider it all. Consider it all. What are we supposed to be doing? Considering, studying, reflecting. What are we meditating on? Come on. Grey's Anatomy, whatever's on YouTube. What are we reflecting on? What are we studying? What are we meditating on? This song, that song, this recipe, that. What are we reflecting on? Is it on Jesus? Is it on the work of the cross? Is it on the finished work? Is it on the victory? Is it on the healing? Is it on the prosperity? Come on. What are we focused on? No guilt, no condemnation. Just change your focus. No guilt, no shame. Just change your focus. Just consider, study, reflect, and meditate on Jesus, who endured from sinners such a bitter hostility against Him. Consider it all. And in comparison with your trials, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. When we don't consider it all, we grow weary. When we don't look to Jesus, we lose heart. We lose heart. Don't lose heart. Take heart in Jesus, in the finished work of the cross. Don't lose heart. Take heart. Right? Consider Him. Reflect on Him. Meditate on Him. Fix your eyes on Jesus and set your mind, your will, your emotions, your personality, your conscience on Him. This is a choice. We have to do this, right? This is us maturing. This is us growing up. This is us becoming who we were called to be. Not insecure, but secure in Him. Walking with authority. Walking by faith. Walking with all the power that's actually dwelling inside of us. Come on, right? Fix your eyes on Jesus. Set your mind, will, emotions, personality, and your conscience on Him. Colossians 3:2. Set your mind and keep the focus continually on the things above, the heavenly things, not on the things on this earth, which have only temporal value. Do you know how much time in our life we waste on temporal value? Things that are going to come and go, right? What is your mind set on? What is your will set on? Man, some of us got some strong wills. Some of y'all raising up some strong-willed children. You know what helps? The word. That's it. Man, what is your will set on? Right? Because if your will's not set on Jesus, you are going to do your own thing. You're going to carve your own path, right? I'm going to do it my way. It's my way or the highway. You know, tell me how it's going on that highway. It seems like a low way, but anyways, right? What is your emotion set on? What is your personality set on? Is it set on Jesus? Is it set on His word? Are you just locked in a box? This is how I am. This is who I am. This is what's happened to me. What is your conscience set on, right? We're free from sin. We're alive in Jesus. Is it on Jesus? Is it set on his word and his will for your life? God has a special plan for you. Man, set your focus on that plan. Is it on the things of this world which are so temporal? They're here and gone. Just like that. When you set your mind on the things above, you start to change. Everything about you starts to change, right? You realize how temporal and fragile this life is. Boom, here, gone. I mean, some of us has lost loved ones and it gets real. Like real. And we realize how fragile this life is, how temporal this life is, right? What am I doing that's eternal? Have you asked yourself this question? Like, what am I doing that's eternal? What am I sharing the love of God to others? Am I fulfilling God's plan and God's purpose for my life? Because I want to discover God's plan. I want to fulfill his purpose. I still ask myself that like every day. Am I fulfilling God's plan? Am I right on track? And I'm only going to know it by renewing my mind. Every day, wake up, renew my mind, repeat. Come on, let's go. Am I fulfilling God's plan? How do we know God's will for our life? Ask your neighbor. Say, how do you know God's will for your life? Is it God's plan? How do we know? Drake knows? No. By renewing our mind to his word. Renewing our mind to his word. Romans 12:2. Do not be conformed to this world, because we so easily can, any longer with its superficial values and customs, but be transformed and progressively changed as you mature spiritually by the renewing of your mind, focusing on godly values and ethical attitudes, so that you may prove. Who may prove? I may prove? No, you may prove. Yeah, I may prove to myself, and you prove to yourself, right? That you may prove for yourself what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect in his plan and purpose for your life. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Fix your eyes on Jesus and give attention to his word. Come on, fix your eyes on Jesus. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Fix your eyes on Jesus. There you go. We need a new song. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Oh, there was a song. Don't get me started. Oh, Lord. Guess what, guys? Okay, so how many of you guys were inspired by Sunday's message? Man, Sunday's message was boom. Just drop the mic, Pastor Dan. Like, we could just meditate on that service for the rest of the year. Okay, I'm just saying. But he was just talking about always learning, always growing. Like, I always want to be the rookie in the game. I always want to be new at something. I always want to grow. So I picked up the piano and I learned jingle bells, E, 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 E. E, F, F, E, E, G, something, whatever. I'm like, yes. Why? Because I want to hear the word and apply. I want to hear the word and grow. I always want to grow. I always want to be having new challenges, new growth in my life. Why? Because we all have the opportunity. We got to make the choice. We got to make the choice to hear and obey, hear and apply, grow. Imagine your brain cells growing. I'm like, man, I need every single one of those. I ain't trying to, I'm like, I'm be young forever. And you know, when you get a little bit older, you're like, you start trying to be like, what was that memory? Oh, and I'm like, no, I'm not going down that road. Come on. These are exercising. Let's grow. Anyways, if you haven't heard that message, get it on YouTube ASAP. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Give your attention to his word. Proverbs 4:20-27. Y'all came for the word today, right? Let's go. My son, give attention. My daughter, come on. Give attention to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. That's your choice. You got to incline. You got to lean in. Not just lean back. Oh, I've heard this before. No, incline your ears. Come on. To my sayings. You got ears to hear? That's what Jesus is always saying. Y'all listening? Wake up. Come on. You came for the word. Don't let them depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart, for they are life to those who find them and health to all of their flesh. Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it springs the issues of life. Put away from you a deceitful mouth. Stop being a liar. Come on. Put it away. Put perverse lips far from you. Woo. Come on. Some of them songs we've been singing. Whoa. You read the word. Put them perverse lips far from you. And let your eyes look straight ahead. That song, there's a country song, and I don't know, sometimes it comes on and like, and I hope she cheats. And then I'm driving and I'm like, and I hope she cheats. I'm like, no, I don't. No thanks. Put them perverse lips away from me. I don't want no one cheating on nobody. It's like, but you're just listening, right? And before you know, you're driving faster. You got this attitude. And you're like, what's wrong? Nothing. Put it away. Put it away. Come on. Let your eyes look straight ahead and your eyelids look right before you. Ponder the path of your feet. Look forward. Look where you're going. Watch where you're going. Watch your step and let all your ways be established. Do not turn to the right or to the left. Remove your foot from evil. That's your choice. You want to step into evil? Go ahead. Or you can remove your foot from evil. It's up to you. Where is your attention? Fix your eyes on Jesus and give attention to his word. You've got to give the attention. Everything in this world is fighting for your attention, fighting for your screen time, fighting for your attention. Why? Because your attention is so valuable. Where you're set on is where you're going. That's where they want your attention. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Give attention to his word. His word is life. His word is life. Fix your eyes on Jesus, and here we go. Do not be wise in your own eyes. This is all of us. Come on. Proverbs 3:5. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Not some of your heart, not a part of your heart, not a quarter of your heart. With what? With all of your heart. And lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Why? Because we can be wise in our own eyes, looking like a fool. Reverence, respect, value the Lord, and depart from evil. Do you see that you have to make a choice to depart, remove your foot, get out, take off, let go? These are choices. We just think that we become a Christian and everything's going to be good. No, it ain't. If you don't choose good, if you choose bad, it's going to be bad, right? It will be health to your flesh. Anybody need some health in their flesh? Come on, let's look to Jesus and strength to your bones. Fix your eyes on Jesus and be diligent to understand spiritual truths. It's time to grow up. We show up to grow up, to have maximum development in every area of our life here at Love Life, right? Mark 4:24. Then Jesus said, who said? Jesus said to them, pay attention to what you hear. And I hope she changed. Girl, pay attention to what you hear. Change the song. Come on. What are we listening to? Pay attention to what you hear. We got all that WandaVision. Rah! Pay attention to what you hear. I'm not saying you can't have fun. I'm not saying you can't watch something. I'm not saying you can't listen to anything. I'm just saying pay attention to what you're doing. Pay attention to what you're focused on. What's the center of your life? What's just consuming you? Pay attention. Listen up, because it's directing your life. And that's where you're headed. And we want to be headed to success. So we got to be focused on Jesus. Jesus said, pay attention to what you hear. By your own standard and measurement, that is, to the extent that you study spiritual truths and apply godly wisdom, it will be measured to you, and you will be given greater ability to respond. That means you hear the word, you apply the word. Come on, greater's coming, greater's coming, and greater's coming, and greater's coming. You hear me in the Sunday service, I'm like, woo, amen, let's go. We hear the word, we apply the word, and I'm like, I get greater every single time. Greater upon greater and greater, greater. The greatest, the greatest. That's right. Why? Because I came to hear. I came to apply. I came to receive, right? And more will be given to you, for whoever has a teachable heart. You already be humbled? Come on. You already have a teachable heart? To him, more understanding will be given. And whoever does not have a yearning for truth, you ain't got no hunger for truth. Why are you here? Come on. This is speaking truth, speaking life. Even what he has will be taken away from him. This is the same scripture in the Passion Translation. Then Jesus said to them, "Be diligent to understand the meaning behind everything you hear. For as you do, more understanding will be given to you. And according to the depth of your longing," I'm hungry for the word. I need the word. Every time I come, I know that God has an answer to my problem. Every time I come, I know that God has an answer to that pain. Every time I come, I know that God has an answer for whatever I'm dealing with Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I know that God has the answer. So I come for the word. I come for the answers. I come for the promise. Come on. And more is given. More is given. More is given. More is given. Greater, 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 right? Understanding we give according to the depth of your longing to understand. I long to understand your word. God, I long to understand who you are. I long to understand who I am in you. I long to understand my purpose and plan and for this world, for this life. I long to understand how am I going to help others. I long, that's why it's consuming me. It's like, what's going to happen to this generation? And so just like, calm down. It's going to be all right, right? It was just funny. Because I'm actually hungry and I long to understand. I want to know and understand God's plan and purpose, right? Much more will be added to you. For those who listen with open hearts will receive more revelation. But those who don't listen with open hearts will lose what little they think they have. Oh, I wanted to say, dang. But I did. Man, you're going to lose whatever you think you have. You think you heard that word before. You think you already heard that message. Come on, you've already heard that story. Man, I've heard Pastor, I've been here 24 years. I've already heard Pastor Dan's stories. I can laugh before the joke is finished. I can finish the joke. I'm like, wait, you forgot a part. Come on, let's go. Because I know that there's something in that story that's going to impact my life today. I know that there's something in that word that God has for me today. And I don't want to miss out. I don't want to miss out on God's understanding for my life. Come on. You hungry? You longing? You want some more? Fix your eyes on Jesus. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Fix your eyes on Jesus and be diligent to understand spiritual truth. Created you a desire to learn and discover who you are through the word. You create that desire. You create that longing. You create it. Every time you have an opportunity to come to church and to hear the word, choose a teachable heart. Choose to let go whatever you've been dealing with and choose a teachable heart to receive, right? Hear the word and apply the word. We have to make a choice to fix our eyes on Jesus. We've got to make that choice, making Jesus and his word the focus of our lives, the center of our lives, the motivation of our lives, the aim of our lives, the application of our lives. Fix your eyes on Jesus and magnify him and not the problem, right? Psalms 34, 4. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let's exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. Whatever you focus on, you magnify. Are you magnifying the Lord? Come on. Are you magnifying the Lord? Are you magnifying the problem? Because you are making it bigger and bigger. You are making the problem bigger and bigger than God. How? Because you magnify it. You're magnifying it. Magnify the Lord. Come on, let's exalt his holy name together. I sought the Lord, he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. Whatever you magnify, come on, it gets bigger and bigger. Focus in on Jesus. Magnify him and his victory at the cross. Magnify him and who you are in him. So what am I going to magnify? I'm going to magnify my I ams. Your I ams, right? I am greatly loved by God. I am a new creation. I am a child of God. Come on, what are you magnifying? Let's magnify his word. Let's magnify who we are in him, right? Let's magnify. That means you're focused on, you're making it bigger and bigger. Fix your eyes on Jesus and forget the past. We got to let it go and continue to press forward. Philippians 3:13 through 15, New Living Translation. You ready for this, guys? There's hope for all of us. Ready? No, dear brothers and sisters, I have not achieved it all yet. Come on. And Paul says he hasn't achieved it all, and homeboy achieved it all. He achieved it all. He's not a homeboy, but. But I focus on this one thing. What is the one thing you're focusing in? Come on, let's let this be the one thing we focus in on. Forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead. I press on to reach the end of the race. Remember that race with endurance? Remember, we're not running somebody else's, but we're running our race. Fix your eyes on Jesus and run your race with endurance and receive the heavenly prize for which God, through Christ Jesus, is calling us. Let all who are spiritually mature agree on these things. And if you disagree at some point, I believe God will make it plain to you. Come on. We run this race with endurance. We forget the past and we look forward. We look forward. None of us have it all together. Duh, right? None of us have it all together. But we will continue to fix our eyes on Jesus, forget the past, and continue to press forward no matter what. No matter what. What are we going to do? We're going to fix our eyes on Jesus and run with endurance. Fix our eyes on Jesus and look away from all that distracts us. We're going to fix our eyes on Jesus and focus in on Him alone. We're going to fix our eyes on Jesus and study, meditate, and reflect on the victory that Jesus did at the cross. We're going to fix our eyes on Jesus and set our mind, our will, our emotions, our personality, and our conscience on Him. Fix our eyes on Jesus. We're going to give attention to His word. Don't be wise in your own eyes. Be diligent to understand spiritual truths. Magnify Him and not the problem. And forget the past and continue to press forward no matter what. God has a special plan for every single one of us. We just have to choose that plan. And I believe us here at Love Life, we choose in that plan every single day that we wake up. We choose that plan to fix our eyes on Jesus and on Him alone and run our race, not anyone else's, right? Because He is with us, we can endure all things. If you're in here tonight and you're like, I want to get on that race, let's go. It starts with Jesus. It starts with believing in Him, calling on His name, and you shall be saved. If you want to receive Jesus tonight, let's say a prayer together. Everybody say with me, say, Jesus, I believe in You. I ask You to save me and set me free. Thank You, Jesus, for this new life. I want all that You have for me. Thank You for helping me set my focus on You. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. And just like that, you enter into the family of God. You call in the name of Jesus, you believe in Him, you receive Him, and you're on this race. And if you receive Jesus tonight for the first time, you can, if you're in the building, you can raise your hands. Our ushers, they've got a booklet about just about salvation. What's your next steps? We have a booklet for you. If you're online, please click that I Receive Jesus button. Give us your address and we will send you that same booklet. We love you guys. I hope you guys receive something tonight. Amen. Amen. Have a great week. We'll see you Sunday.